Alright, before this video starts, I just want to give you a little bit of context. What happened is that I got this figure and his bicep was backwards and I couldn't fix him unless I took him apart. So that's what I did. I didn't record it, unfortunately, how I was fixing the figure, but I'm sorry, but I eventually did fix him. So this is kind of like a review slash fail. I don't know. This video is pretty long and I also want to do a language warning. There's a lot of cussing. Please, if cussing bothers you a lot, please don't watch this video. Just don't. Okay, well, thank you. I'm gonna transfer you to the next clip. All right, so welcome back to my channel. I just got this in the mail, Omega Red. Now, he did came with his comic. It came loose, by the way. He added the comic that it came with, and he came with the back piece. And there are some other figures of the Wave. I already have this Black Panther. From this way, if I have this one and this one, I might get this one, but I definitely want this one. Okay, so let's get Omega Red out of his wrapping paper. This is the first time I'm gonna be looking at it. Oh, damn, he's huge. Okay, he does come, oh man, okay, I already see him some flaws right now. Okay, you know what, wait, what the fuck happened here? Look at this. What the hell is this? That's not right. What's going on here? His bicep is on his tricep side. What the fuck is going on? Okay, hold on. Well, I'm gonna pass look at that, but that's definitely not right. Well, at least his joints are all smooth and stuff, but that is not right. What the hell happened there? Okay, so I'm gonna pass look at that and let's look at his Dude, what the hell is that? I'm pretty sure some people could have probably passed notice, but I just hate it. Even as a kid, I remember playing with toys and I hated when I saw people with the tricep in the bicep side. Now, he did come with his coils. And they are flexible, so let me just put one of them on the wrong hand because this is definitely gonna be the one. Is there hard to put? Okay, no, they're actually pretty easy to the point that I feel like it's gonna be loose all the time. Now, they are very long. Wow, to the point that they're kind of heavy, so it goes down. But the figure itself looks badass, except for that little freaking flaw. Oh, they're actually pretty, they stay put, but Jesus Christ, dude. Oh, he can't really move his head at all, so. Not just because of this one flaw. I have no idea how this happened. And I didn't even saw that. I don't know if you have a clear shot on that, but look at that. Even this is backwards compared to how it's supposed to look like this. So I don't know if to get another one. Oh, his finger articulation is pretty good. I'm sorry. So they look awkward, though. For a punch. So that's definitely very annoying and awkward. At least he can go pretty far down. His hair is rubber over here compared to this side. It's very hard. Something that I noted immediately as soon as I got him out of the package is that this is kind of yellow compared to this one that is kind of pink. It is not supposed to do that. It's not just a pain getting old, I guess. And this is some pain rubbing off. But I'm definitely gonna say something about this to the guy who I just bought it from. Because what the hell happened here? Oh, I'm so bothered by that. Hopefully I can look past it in the future. But hey, at least he's a fucking tall ass figure. Or as long as I have it like probably like this. And his armor piece is probably gonna like cover it, right? So I don't know. That really bothers me, though. I can't stand him up. He appears to not stand up by himself. I feel like he's gonna fall. There we go. But looking at the tentacles thingy, they have some pretty badass detail. You will never see this with Hasbro. Very badass, but I've never seen that. Or either I haven't seen enough reviews to notice it. I have no idea what happened there. But looking at the head sculpt, it looks badass. It's definitely. Oh, look at that hair, how bendable that is. That's very nice. And look at all that paint, all that shading in the face. Scary as hell. All the detail. I kind of like this paint, all like metally. I think I can look past this, especially because this is covered and I'm probably gonna have it like this. So I think I can look past it. But that is not right. Some shading right here. We already mentioned about the boots. Some metallic clean paint. At least we don't have no paint issues, which is what I like, except for these pieces and this pieces and the feet, which I'm not gonna look into. Some finger articulation, very nice. All the joints are very stiff, so that's good. Very awesome though. Okay, let me try to put him with his tentacles. And meanwhile, I'll show you a clip of how he looks and in some like cartoons and stuff like that. The figure itself is pretty epic, just to, you know, be upset with it. The joints are so tight, but so like if he was new, he's I don't, but I think the figure itself is pretty cool. All the nice, as I said, all the, it's pretty much like a fucking new figure, but it's just that thing bothers me so much. I mean, not really, not anymore. I think I can, I might, I don't know. It's very scary because this plastic is not like Hasbro, all bendable and nice. This shit is hard. But I might try to take this out. Well, I'm sorry, you haven't seen it. I might try to take this little peg out and flip this around somehow. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Like, I might flip around the bicep or something. I'm gonna try. Oh man, but it might fuck up the articulation, making it all loose and stuff. So I'm very scared, but I'm gonna try. I'm gonna cut to the next clip. It might be articulation or me actually fixing this figure. So I'll be right back. All right, so I fixed him. I can't believe I did it, but I fixed him. His bicep is okay now. Oh crap, come on, man. Come on, man. It's come on, man. Okay, the thing is that you can't really see it. Something that I noticed, now his bicep does look weird. But it's supposed to look like this, and it does have like the Y part. Okay, something that I noticed when I was fixing is that this bicep is this bicep, meaning that they got two of the left side, left. They got two of the left bicep, and they used it like that. What I did to fix them is I took this little pin right here out. Oh, come on, man! Look, I don't know if you can see it. It might look weird, more weird. I'm more comfortable looking at it like this, though. It does look weird because it's not supposed to be this bicep. This is the left one, making it look like freaking, I don't know. It looks weird, though. It looks like he's on fucking steroids. What I did is took this pin out. I took this one out. And I spread it to the point that this little, like his, what's this, his wrist and most of this hand, I got it out. I flipped it around. I flipped this thing around as well. Making, this is the inside part, and this is the outer side. So that's why I know that this is, because the vein right here is supposed to be this vein right here. I don't know if they mirrored it and they just look the same. I don't know. but I was able to fix it. I put it on hot water, put it on the microwave for 3 minutes, put that thing in there for like a minute or two, and then I took it out. I was able to fix it, switch this thing out, and I already told you the rest of the process. I put it back in, and I grabbed some like pinzas. I don't know how you call those. I put a picture of it right here somewhere of how those look. And I used them to pressure this thing and put it on cold water, and there we go. We got this thing back on his regular form, even though they got me the wrong bicep. Still, very cool figure, man. Can't believe I fixed him. And he didn't got loose. Thank goodness. And I think does he have more range? Does he or does he not? Okay, it looks like he's the same, pretty much the same. He didn't got loose. Still working pretty well, so very proud of that. So let me just show you where he's gonna go on my shelf. He's gonna be articulation, man. We haven't gone through that, so let's go through that.
Oh man, this is a long fucking video. All right, so his head can go not really that far up. He can go that far down. He can go all the way up if it wasn't for the shoulder pads. He can go all the way 360, but this thing is gonna get loose. Hopefully it doesn't break. Bicep swivel. Double jointed elbows on both hands. No wrist rotation, but he does have finger articulation, and yeah, that's about it right there. Yeah, it doesn't look like he has any wrist or anything. He does have it right here. Waist swivel, ab crunch, go that far. He can go that far back, but this thing does get in the way. It's kind of annoying. And he does a ponytail, and it can rotate very smoothly. He has a thigh swivel, double jointed knees. He has an ankle rocker. He can go that far up, that far down, and he does not. Oh, wait, actually, he can go up that far, he can go that far on, but he does not have an ankle rocker. Slightly, but it goes more outward than inward, which is what we need most. So, let me show you where he's gonna go on the shelf real quick.
Alright, so as you saw in the beginning, this is where I put him, Choking Colossus, and I did move a lot of pieces like Deadpool's over here now, Black Spidey's over here, and all of these figures are kind of moved. The reason why I'm doing this is because I bought a bunch of figures and they're pretty big, so I want to make some space, especially because I feel like I'm misusing this space like Avengers. They have a bunch of space back there. When all of these is getting stacked up, all of this space is getting stacked up. I feel like this is a waste of space as well, so I'm going to need to move this as long as I get my other robot big figure. And then this space right here, I feel like I'm save for future waves. And this space, I'm also feeling like this is getting a waste of space. So I'm definitely going to change a lot of things. So I'm thinking of just putting like X-Men up here and Spider-Man and taking this little crossover out. So I don't know. Leave some comments down below what you think I should do and if I made the right choice on moving the bicep. Leave a like. Thanks for watching the video and I'll see you on the next one.